can I sit down and have a conversation with me? People don't admit it and they don't think about it too much, but they do. Every day they're talking in their own head. In this case, there's another you out there.
If you open your brain wide enough to think of what infinity truly means, then it's not just possible that there are other Earths, it's actually like completely logical that there are.
This is Dr. Joan Tallis of SETI. Is someone there?
Where are you? This is Dr. Joan Tallis.
No way!
What is that? What does that mean?
The astrophysics of it is definitely based on some sort of reality, some sort of truth. We twisted it for the purposes of metaphor.
In the grand history of the cosmos, our Earth is replicated elsewhere.
Take a look at that image looming behind Brett. It's fantastical. It's not presuming to be fact. However, there's another way of looking at this film too, and that is where you really do see it as being factual or perhaps speculative.
Maybe there's another way of seeing this world. If any small variation arises, they look this way, you look that way, suddenly maybe everything changes. And now you begin to wonder, what else is different?
He really wants the science to be correct. He thinks popular culture should try and do science as correct as possible.
One of the challenges you have is prolonged weightless conditions. But once there, you have no idea what you're about to encounter. What really are the beings from this other planet like? I think it's popular and appealing because it's such an extraordinary idea. There are more worlds in space than there are grains of sand on all the beaches of Earth. Amazing. Now let's take it the next step. Is it imaginable that one is in fact not the only one? In the case of the multiverse, there could be an infinite number.
If you shuffle that deck of particles infinitely, you are bound to repeat the same patterns. So technically, literally, not just is life possible in the cosmos, but a literal duplicate Earth is possible, which means that duplicate yous are possible.
You're up there and I'm up there.
That's just too much.
The possibilities are phenomenal, and if the equations can be believed, somewhere out there, it's possible to find another Earth and another you. What would we say to ourselves? What would we learn from ourselves? What would we really like to see if we could stand outside ourselves and look at us?
It can connect with people in a certain way or make people connect with science. His authenticity and knowledge about the cosmos play this very, very crucial role for the other Earth plot.
It's just a lovely thing to daydream on, the idea that, like, some version of you could have done it better.
You don't know what's out there.
That's why I would go.
It's mind-boggling. Whatever we have discovered to date would shrink to nothingness compared with what we have yet to learn.
One might say that you have an exact mirror image which suddenly is shattered, and there's a new reality. And therein lies the opportunity and the mystery. What else? What new? What now?